That's all I can really say right now.
DaVonté, were you happy with the final shot you guys forced?
Yeah. I mean, it was a contested 25-footer. It was just a really good shot. We remember that. I couldn't have contested any more better without fouling. So, he did his job. He just better off.
Josh, this was a game where you guys really seemed to have the advantage on the boards down low. How did they react to that? They didn't put a lot of big guys on you. How did they guard you with the size that they used?
Well, Denandro had his first game back, and so we kind of take advantage of that. We thought it'd be a little bit rusty down there. And then they used like Mike Anderson and other guys, and so when they were guarding me, try to get exposed to mismatches down in the paint. But
DaVonté, you guys held them to without a field goal for about 7 minutes in the first half, and then you guys left that zone. Do you think maybe you should have gone back to it a little bit more in the second half, tried it out again?
No. We rock with whatever coach thinks is good, and if we don't feel like something's going to work, then I'll tell them, or someone will say something. But I think at that stage of the game, I think we doing a decent job, doing a better job, but they had shoes on the floor, and it was hard to go to, especially with Andrew playing the way he did. So, no, I stand down with Coach when he called it, when he decided to do it.
DaVonté, were you happy with how you guys defended William Gaz in the hole today?
No. We lost, so I don't know his stats, but he's still considered his stats may not have been crazy, but he still considered it a game. He dominated the game using his point guard ability. That's why he's one of the best point guards in the league and improving.
Josh, without Upshaw, how different was their game? How different was their style of play from the first game?
Well, for us, we thought that we could close the paint, drive a lot more because there wasn't the presence inside. And then rebounding was also another big thing. We pretty much only had Sean Kenton there rebounding, but credit the wings for them. Mike Anderson was crafting the boards a lot and really caused a lot of pressure for us to box out. So I think they did a good job with their lack of size.
You put pretty much every big man on their team in foul trouble. Do you feel like you guys were effective at executing that game plan down low?
Yeah, I think we took it right to them. We tried to attack Sean Kenton and get him out of the game early and to bring in their subs. And I think we did that. But I think we executed the offensive game plan a little bit more.
How much of a frustration comes from the way it ended versus if you were ever in the game?
I mean, any game where you lose like that on the buzzer beater, it hurts, but it hurts especially a lot more when it's a rival. So.
Was there a sense of like you guys didn't lose this game and you kind of had it won and then you won it back?
In the first half, we jumped out to a pretty big lead. I don't think we were expecting or something like that. And I don't think we did a good job of controlling that and, you know, really breaking down the wall and you know, and taking control and pretty much just dominating the game from that point on. We let them get back in it, and at the end, it's a 2-point game. We had a three, and then came back, and we scored, and tied the game, and came back.
DaVonté, did you feel like that in an emotional game like this, how big was the officiating?
I think the officiating was great. They called it both ways pretty even. We're not going to make every shot, and they're not going to make every call. So you can't really say anything about the officials. They did a great job. They do the best every time. So I don't think, obviously it has its ways and momentum, but it's all part of basketball, and every team has to face it.
When you look back, maybe earlier in the game, is there a point where you thought, well, maybe if we defended Andrews a little differently earlier on, he wouldn't have caught fire as much?
I don't know what game you're talking about, but he was on fire from the get-go. I think he came in, he's been on fire the last four games. He's him and Tyrone Wallace, so those were pretty much 18, 16, I think, four or something. So he's been on fire the whole last four games. So I don't think anything we do just enhance him. He's just on a tear right now.
Do
question, do you have that last book there at half point?
I had it, but somebody from the team came up, he didn't do